If I'm in a hotel and I call the front desk, they always say, "We'll have that right up to you, ma'am."
Your voice can change, and I'm going to show you how right now.
This is me, David.
I'm a little mystified as to why I talk the way I talk. Do you guys think I sound good?
When you say it like that, you do.
How and when did I learn to sound gay?
I'm used to hearing my voice now. When I would first hear it, I would be appalled.
Did you ever listen to yourself and think, God, I sound gay?
I'd have to say, if I told you no, I'd be lying.
A lot of gay men are self-conscious about sounding gay because we were persecuted for that when we were young.
When I was in third grade, people started making fun of the way I talked, and that's when the bullying started.
I felt so disconnected. I wasn't sure who to be or what to sound like.
This thing of hypermasculinity is such a conscious performance in gay male culture all the time. It just feels so oppressive.
Somebody will say, I didn't know you were gay. And it's like, why does that make me feel good? And I hate myself for thinking that.
You know, all of that self-hatred and anxiety really gets shoved under, and it can last for generations.
I don't remember what I sounded like growing up.
September 1993, you sounded like a straight boy. By May, you were sounding pretty gay.
I don't think there is such a thing as sounding straight.
People think my straight friend Chris sounds gay.
We need two strawberries.
My gay friend Matt is the straightest sounding guy I know.
I perform like every one of my other brothers.
Perhaps you picked this up when you were young by listening more to women than to men.
Stop it. Mm-hmm. Stop it.
You're going, stop it.
Okay.
Stop it.
What's wrong with sounding like you are who you are?
I love my gay boys. I don't have to come out to anyone. I say hello, and it's a done deal.
There's nothing wrong with you.
We enunciate.
Love, love, resonation.
I think I sound like a very small man. You know, like this high.